Hello student, welcome you all for a video lecture on a finite state and automata. Today we will see the introduction of finite state machine. As I said in the previous class, the finite state machine which accept string as a input and produce either of the two values, that is accept or a reject. The machine, it will take a string character one by one, left to right, single character at a time. Then it will check its present state and the character read. Based on that, it will move to a next state. If the machine read all the input and it reached the accepting state, then it will produce accepting as the output. If the input is read and machine still in the intermediate state, then the machine state that the string is rejected. So today we see the first class of a finite state machine called as a deterministic finite state machine. The name itself indicates the machine is deterministic, means its future is already determined. So based on the given input, the future or a state the machine move, that is fixed here. So deterministic finite state machine, the examples are, we can take an elevator as an example, where assume that I am in a ground floor. After entering the elevator, I am going to press a 4 because I want to move to a fourth floor. What is the current state of the machine? The current state of the machine is ground floor. After giving the command 4, after pressing the button 4, the machine will move to a fourth floor. So it is fixed. So if I give the command 4, the machine will not move to a fifth floor and so on. So that is the one example for a deterministic finite state machine. I can give another example for a deterministic finite state machine. Take your fan as an example. So initially assume that your fan is in a idle state, means it is in a off mode. When I press the switch button, the machine will move from off state to on state. So moving to a on state is fixed here. It is determined, it is fixed. So these are the some example for deterministic finite state machine. Let's move to the formal definition of a finite state machine, deterministic finite state machine. Formally, the deterministic finite state machine is defined by 5 tuples, k, summation, do, s and a. Where k is a finite set of states. So you are going to draw a deterministic finite state machine by using a state, inputs, accepting state and a start state. Where k defined what? The finite set of states. So how many states you are going to use to draw a particular finite state machine or comes under this. Next, the summation is the input alphabet. S is a one of the state which is called as a start state. Where a is a subset of the k. K is nothing but a state here. So one or more states are the final states in a DFSM. Where delta is the transition function. So this delta is mapped by taking a states and the input symbols. So here you are going to draw a transition table by considering the states which are there in the DFSM and the input symbols. So row values are the states and column values are the input symbols. So you are going to map each state with the input symbols. Next, the notations used to draw the DFSM are, you are going to use a circle, where circle represent the state. So these states you can name by taking any of the characters or a numbers. So here I had given a name for this circle is A. Next, the arrow or a edge indicate the transition. Transition shows the change of the state. So the arrow indicate transition here. Next, the double circle indicate it is a final state or a accepting state. Next, the arrow with label. So you are changing the state from one to another after accepting a string characters. So those characters you are going to specify on a arrow. Those are called as a transitions with the labels. So one of the example how the DFSM looks is given here. So in this case, the alphabets are A and B. So alphabet equal to A comma B, star. Star indicates this alphabet may occur 0 or any number of times. The star indicates the occurrence of A and B in the machine is 0 or any number of times. So here I had drawn one DFSM where it accepting the strings starting with the A. Okay, this is just an example how to draw this. I will explain in the next videos. So here the states are Q0, Q1 and Q2. Okay, among this the Q0 is a start state. How to recognize it is a start state? Because arrow is coming from the outside world towards this state. So if such cases are there, then those are called as a start state. For any DFSM, there will be only one start state. Next, double circle state. As I said, it is a accepting state, final state or a terminating state. So Q1 is a final state here, whereas Q2 is a one of the intermediate state in the machine. So assume that if I am in a Q0 state, after reading a input character A, I am going to change the state from Q0 to Q1. Once I reach a Q1, if a input character A or a B comes, I will accept and I will be in the same state. So arrow towards itself indicate it is a loop. And here I had given A comma B. It doesn't mean that it is accepting A and B at the same time. As I said, the DFSM, it will accept a single character at a time. If A come, it will accept and it will be in the same state. If B come, it will accept and it will be in the same state. It doesn't mean it is accepting A and B at the same time. Next, if I am in a Q0 state and B comes, then I will change the state from Q0 to Q2. Once I reach the Q2, if A and B comes, I will accept and I will be in the same state. So here you can give the transitions as a forward transitions, or you can give a backward transition also if required, or you can give a loop transitions. So transitions are three types here. One is a forward transition, one is a backward transition, and one is a loop transition. So you give the transition based on the condition. Next, if I want to represent this DFSM by using this 5 tuples. Okay, so what will be the K value? As I said, K is a finite set of states. So how many states are there in this DFSM? 3 states are there. So I am going to write those as the values for this K. So Q0, Q1, Q2 are the states here. Summation indicate what? The input alphabet. So what are the input alphabet I am accepting here? A and B. So I'll write A comma B. Next, S. S is what? Start state. So which is a start state in this DFSM? Q0 is a start state. So I'll write S equal to what? Q0. Next, what is the A here? Accepting state. What is the A here? A is a accepting state, and what I should write for this A? So in this DFSM, Q1 is an accepting state. So I'll write here Q1. Next, delta function, or you can say the DO. DO is nothing but a transition function. As I said, it is mapped by using a number of states and the alphabets. So here I'm going to take, so transition function I'll write as, I'll take A and B as a column values because these are the alphabet in the DFSM. Next, what are the states of DFSM? Q0, Q1, Q2 are the states here. So Q0, Q1, Q2 are the row values. A and B are the column values. So I will write the transition table here. Or you can say I am going to map state with the input symbol. So if I am in the Q0 state, after accepting the A, where I go? I go to the Q1 state. So I am in a Q0 state, after accepting A, where I will make the transition, I will go to the Q1 state, so I will write here Q1. If I am in a Q0 state and I accept a B, then I will change my state to Q0 to Q2, so I will write here Q2. Next, if I am in the Q1 state and accept a A, I will be in the same state, so I will write here Q1. If I am in a Q1 state and accept a B, where I move? I move to a same state, so I'll write here Q1. Next, if I am in a Q2 state, after accepting the A, C, input symbol. So I will be in the same state, so I will write here Q2 itself. Check out here. I am in a Q2 state. After accepting the A, I will be in the same state. For B also, I will be in the same state. So this is a representation of your DFSM by using these 5 tuples. Let us see some example how to draw a DFSM for a given language. So here the given language is, or a given question is, draw a DFSM to accept the strings of A's and B's having exactly one A. So what are the alphabets in the language? The alphabets in the language are A and B. So I'll write here alphabet equal to A comma B. Next, after writing the alphabet, what is the second condition they are given? The A should occur exactly one time in the string. So this language accepts the strings of A's and B's where the occurrence of A is one time. So before the construction of a DFSM, you must write the string for the language, valid strings for the language. So the valid strings for the language are, so has, according to the question, it should accept what? Exactly one A. So A is in the language. Next, A, B in the language. B, A, B is in the language. So check out the occurrence of A. They had not given any condition for the occurrence of B. They had given only condition for the occurrence of A. That is, it should occur exactly one time. Where? They had not given. It may come first, last, or in between. But the occurrence of A is one time in the string. Next, B, B, A is a valid string. Next, A, B, B, B is a valid string, and so on. So, and infinite strings are there in the language, which are valid here. At the same time, you can write the invalid strings also. So, what are the invalid strings here? Where the A occur more than one time. So, AA is an invalid string. Next, ABA is an invalid string. Next, AAB is an invalid string. So, check out the occurrence of A here. It is more than one time. Next, BAA is an invalid string. So, first, you must understand what are strings in the language, valid strings in the language. So, these are the valid strings, these are the invalid strings. So, whatever DFSM you construct, it should accept the valid strings and it should not accept what? The invalid strings. So, how to draw the DFSM? The next question is, see, always you check out the valid string list, check out the minimum string occurring in the language. So, minimum string means which has a length 1. Okay, so this is the minimum string which is occurring in the language. So first, you draw a DFSM to accept this, okay? So I will start with the start state, okay? I will name this as the A. Next, I am going to accept the minimum string. So what is the minimum string here? A is a minimum string. So after accepting A, I will change my state. So this is accepted, so I will make this as a final state. Because A is accepting here, so when you are in an initial state, when you read the input character A, then you are going to change your state from A to say it has a B, and A is accepting because it is a valid string. So I am going to make this as a accepting state. Next, you think about remaining strings characters. So here, as I said, the deterministic, the nature of the deterministic is you should show exactly one transition for a given input. So here from A state, I had shown the transition for A, small a, but B ka had not yet shown. Check out the B state. B state, I had not shown A and B, both transitions. Both transitions. Next, you should think about a B transition. So where I should show the B transition? Shall I show a loop or shall I give a transition to other states? So here, if I take a loop for B, what happen? If B comes, any number of time B comes, it will be accepted and it will be in the A state only. It will move to the final state only when the A will occur in the string. So here, if any number of B's come, it will be get accepted and it will be in the same state. It will move to the final state only when the A will come. So I had shown the BK transition. Next, you should check for A and B transition of a state B. So here, if I give the B transition and A transition has a loop, what happen? What happen? It start accepting what? If A come, it will move from A to B. So A is get accepted. If one more A come, it will accept and it will be in the same state. So it is a final state. Whether AA is a valid string for a given language? No, it is not a valid string. It comes under what? Invalid string. So it should not be accepted by your DFSM. So A ka transition I can't show here. But I can show B transition because there is a no condition for the occurrence of B in the language. So B may occur any number of times. Then the next question arises, where I should show the transition of B. So B transition I will show to the next state. If B come, move to the next state. Okay, say it as a C state. Next, for A and B transition of C state, I will show it as a loop. So if one A come, it will move to the final state. If another A come, sorry, this is for A. If another A come, it will change the state from B to C, and C is not a final state. So if two A's come, then it will be in the dead state. And after that, if any A and B comes, that will not accept it. Okay, so this is a DFSM to accept what? The strings of A's and B's having exactly one A. So check out whether it accepts all the valid strings or no. So A is a valid string, check out. I'm going to start from the start state only. If A come, I will change the state to B, and B is what? It is an accepting state. So this will get accept. Check for the AB. Start from the start state. If A come, I will change the state from A to B. If B come, I will accept and I will be in the B state, where B is a final state. So this is also accepting. Next, BAB. So if B come, I will accept and I will be in the same state. When A come, I will move to the state B, and if one more B come, I will accept and it will be in the same state. So this is also accepted by your DFSM. Check out the next thing, BBA. If one B come, it will accept and it will be in the same state. Second B, it will accept and it will be in the same state. When A come, then only it will change the state from A to B, where B is what? Accepting state. So after accepting the string, it should be in the final state. Then you are going to say the string is accepted by your DFSM. Check out the last string here. If A come, see, I am going to start from the start state. If A come, I will change the state from A to B. Next, if one B come, I will accept, I will be in the same state. For second B, I will accept and I will be in the same state. For third B, I will accept and I will be in the same state. So this is also accepted. You take any string and check out with this DFSM. Those all are accepted by this DFSM. Next, we check out the non-acceptable strings. If AA comes, see, I'm going to start from the state A only. If 1A come, I'll move from A to B. If 2A come, I'll move from B to C. Where C is what? It is not a final state. So this is not accepted. Next, ABA. If A come, I will move from A to B. If B come, I will accept, I will be in the same state. If one more A come, I will change the state from B to C, where C is a dead state. Okay, so these strings are not accepted by your DFSM. So before the construction of DFSM, if you write down the valid and invalid string, it is easy for you people to check the things. And you should be clear that what all strings are accepted by the DFSM and what are not. Next, you represent this DFSM by using a 5 tuples. As I said, what will be the K here? K equal to the number of states. So how many states are there? 3 states are there. just to write the label of these three states. A, B, C are the states. Next, summation, it indicates the input symbol that you are accepting. So what are the input symbol you are accepting here? A, B. Next, the S. S is what? The start state. So which is the start state in this? A is the start state. So S equal to A. Next, what will be the A here? Accepting state. The state which is drawn by using a double circle. So B is a accepting state. Next, you should write what? The transition function. The transition function, as I said, you should write the table where states are the row values and inputs are the column values. Next, you write the transition of these states with the input symbol. So when you are in a A state, when you are going to see the input character A, you will change from A to B. When you are in a A state, when you see the A symbol, you will change your state from A to B. Next, when you are in a A state and you see the input symbol B, then you are going to be in the same state, that is A. Next, when you are in a B state, after accepting the input symbol A, you will change your state from B to C. When you are in a B state, after accepting the B symbol, you are going to be in the same state. Next, when you are in a C state, after accepting the input symbol A, you will be in the same state. And for B also, you are going to be in the same state. So this is a construction of a DFSM where the occurrence of A is exactly one time. Thank you.